Has AI created new jobs? With the sudden exponential growth of AIs like ChatGPT, Midjourney, and more, what does this mean for the job market? And I'm not just talking about the United States. AI is innately digital, so people can use and develop it from anywhere in the world. As the tech world expands, so do their jobs. In this video, I'll be showing you a new job that ChatGPT has created, and one that I think will be of major significance in the future. Good software engineers have been doing it for decades. What am I talking about? Prompt engineering. Back in the 1990s, in the early age of the internet, information was not as easy as it is to find now. Imagine you wanted to buy a baseball bat. You go to Google and you type in bat. Most of the first page results are going to be a bat, the animal. If I click the shopping tab, instantly almost all the results become baseball bats. It's super easy to find the thing you're searching for. 2 to 3 decades ago, I would have had to search baseball bat, or buy baseball bats, or baseball bats dash sale to get the same results. These are all simple examples of prompt engineering. It is a skill to know how to search for information. To be a good programmer, you need to be able to search for information efficiently and accurately. The same thing goes for talking to AI language models like ChatGPT. Prompt engineering is the process of creating, crafting, and refining the prompts that you ask ChatGPT. Just like Google, I have an envisioned output goal, but to really achieve the output that I want, I need to give it the right input. I need to give it the right prompt. The premise of the job is that you are able to alter vague prompts into detailed, more well-written prompts to produce a better output. This is a skill that can be learned and can benefit you in other areas of life as well. Let's jump straight into it. The first thing to learn is what I like to call continuance techniques. So to demonstrate this, I'm gonna head on over to ChatGPT. Now I'm gonna ask it a simple prompt. Why are cars important? And ChatGPT will start giving me a response. This is the output. My prompt, why are cars important, was the input. And what ChatGPT is saying right now, cars are important for a variety of reasons, etc., etc., is the output. The reason why I call this a continuance technique is because we are continuing our original prompt. We're not giving it another prompt. So to get a different side of the story here, I can ask it, on the other hand. Now it will give me a different side to the story. It will give me the negative impacts of cars, not the positives that it gave me in the first one. This can be very useful to gather multiple data points before you make a decision. So by giving it more detailed prompts, different replies, and other things to think about, you will get better outputs. For example, if for some reason I wanted to use this output in some website copy or an essay, and one of my requirements was for this to be funny, I can ask it something like, make it funnier. So as you notice, when I type make it funnier, it just gave me a couple jokes about cars. What I really wanted it to do was take this prompt and make it funnier. So this is what prompt engineering is. I'm gonna ask it something to get the response that I want. So I can say something like, why are cars negative, and make the response funny. So you can see here, after asking why are cars negative and make the response funny, it gives me a couple more jokes, and then it gives me a more detailed response that has both negatives and positives. So the next thing you need to do to be a good prompt engineer is to give ChatGPT a role. For example, if I wanted to find out why my car shook every time I pressed the brakes, I could ask ChatGPT to take a role of a mechanic and explain it to me, instead of just giving me a generic answer like Google would. Why does my car shake when I apply the brakes? There we go. It's gonna give me a generic response that gives me several reasons. So this is something you would find if you just Googled my prompt. Why does my car shake when I apply the brakes? Now, you can give it a role. So you can tell ChatGPT to take the role of a person, and then it will actually respond as that person's role. So ChatGPT is kind of becoming an actor with all the information in the world. So now I can just ask it, give me that response as a mechanic. Look at the response. It says, as a mechanic. So it took that role of a mechanic and just applied it to itself. And now it's giving me a better response, something that I would actually expect from a mechanic and something that might lead to me diagnosing my car more accurately. And you can also change the role on the fly. So I can tell it, give me that response as a comedian, and then it gives me a joke. As a comedian, I can tell you that the reason your car is shaking when you apply the brakes is because it's trying to shake off the bad memories of all the terrible karaoke you've been singing in it. And then it says, either way, shake it off and drive safely. And you can do this with any prompts. You can tell it to take the role of a software engineer. You can tell it to take the role of pretty much any character that it understands. It can even do popular celebrities and characters. So I can ask it something like, tell me about New York City as Batman. Okay, so that didn't get the output that I wanted. So let's try a better prompt. Take the role of Batman and tell me about New York City. Boom, there we go. Now ChatGPT takes the role as Batman, a fictional character. Tells me about New York City. So you can use this to make ChatGPT respond in the role of a celebrity, in the role of basically any abstract concept of any role you can think of. I'm sure you could even ask it to respond as R2-D2 or something. So those are the two beginner things you can do to start working towards bettering your prompt engineering skills. This article is one of the external resources that I found super useful. It goes over what prompt engineering is, and it has some nice little graphics here. It teaches you about the principles, like a prompt guides the model to generate useful output. So this gives you some examples and ideas, like show the model what you would like to see, and this will further your knowledge. This link will be in the description, so make sure to go look at that if you want to learn more about prompt engineering. Prompt engineering is being described as the career of the future. A post on Medium by Shubham Sabu states, with the no-code revolution around the corner and the coming of new age technologies like GPT-3, we may see a stark difference between the career of today and the careers of tomorrow. And I agree with him here. I think that prompt engineering definitely could be a career in the future as the AI field expands. So, if you're planning on going to university, I definitely recommend picking up something like a computer science degree, because this is where the AI field is. On Twitter, ChatGPT Chef tweeted, "Prompt engineering is a career option now, thanks to ChatGPT." And I agree with him. As ChatGPT becomes better and search engines start incorporating more AI stuff, it will be more beneficial than ever to be able to pinpoint any data that you want on the internet. This skill starts with prompt engineering. So get studying, get practicing. This skill could definitely make you some money and pay off in the future. Thank you for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. And make sure to leave a comment what you think about all of this. Do you think prompt engineering can become an actual career? Let me know in the comments down below. Peace.